Welcome to another episode of the Free Your Energy Podcast. In this episode, we're going to go over the emotions, the setbacks, the story, the victories of finishing a project, of taking something from an idea to bringing it to the market, to bringing it to completion. For me, I'm an author, so what I will be talking about is how it feels to finish writing a book. I just finished my 9th book, Loving Yourself Properly. So sit back for the next 10 minutes and join us on this ride as we dive into the emotions of finishing a project. So the very first question we have to ask ourselves is why we even began the project. So in my lane, the question is, why did I want to write the book? So the book is called Loving Yourself Properly. I started this book about 2 years ago, around July 2019. And it was at a time in my life where I was riding a high. I was feeling really good. My book Care Package and Free Your Energy had just came out in 2018 and 2019. You know, I was feeling good. I was in shape. I was really loving my life. But the question of what is self-love is a question that would not leave my head. I kept thinking about it every single day. You know, what is self-love? What is self-love? What does it mean? So then, you know, the Virgo in me, I started asking other people, hey, what does self-love mean to you? What does self-love mean to you? And I started getting a lot of different responses. And what I recognized is that there is no universal, this is self-love. And so since I saw that void in that space, not necessarily being defined, I wanted to come into that space and investigate that space and sit in that space and really create the conversation for other people to hold within themselves and within their families and within their communities. Like, what is self-love? How do we use it? Do we have it? Is it something we earn? Is it something we create? You know, when I think about the question, why did I want to write the book? The answer is I wanted to fill that void and fill that space. And I felt called to do it. So why not me? The very next question is, what do you hope to accomplish with this book? I think this type of question is interesting. A lot of the times when people tell you their goals, you judge their goals, you know? And then even when we're telling other people our own goals, sometimes we judge our goals. Sometimes we say to ourselves, oh, don't say that because this person might think this or this person might think that. And that's one of my angles in the book is I want people to be authentic with where they are. I want people to be authentic with what they want. I want people to be authentic with who they are. You know, in the book, I talk about this idea of being perfect, this perfectionism that so many people chase. And I try to invite the reader into a space where they recognize that you don't have to be perfect. Two, you don't have to be a presenter, meaning you don't have to present yourself for other people to like you. And that's one of the key things I'm preaching in the book. So for me, when I tell you what I hope to accomplish with the book, there's a few goals to know. Right. Obviously, as an author and as a business owner, there's first the author lane is you want to make great work. You want to make work that will last past the generation. You want to make work that people will read and they'll say, wow, this was so good. This changed my life. This impacted my life. Friend, you need to read this book. Cousin, you need to read this book. Social media, you guys need to read this book. So from the author angle, I would like to assume that all authors like that. That confirmation that their work justifies someone's life or improved someone's life or gave someone a new outlook or new lens. So from an author angle, of course, for sure, let's just call that impact. We definitely want to make an impact. Now, as a business owner, of course, 100%, you know, as the rappers say, you know, get the bag. Like, of course, you want to make sure that your product, that the thing that you're releasing, the thing that you're bringing to the market, that it serves your customer. But you also want to make sure that you get paid. So I'm 100% looking for that and hoping that, you know, the product speaks for itself, takes care of the customer, and I hope that the returns are great. Lastly, for the reader, and I think that's the best way to look at, you know, especially when you're bringing something to a market or to people, when you're creating something from scratch, I feel like that's one of the best ways you can look at it is you're looking at it through the lens of, you know, what you are. If you're a basketball player, a skier, an author, a lawyer, looking at it through the lens of your business, if it is a business thing, and then obviously looking at it through the lens of the person or people or community or group of people receiving on the other end. So for me, I would say if the book can create conversations or help or show my reader how to hold conversations around self-love. And the interesting thing about self-love is like you have to break that down into other categories. So there's parts in the book where we talk about shame, we talk about community, we talk about isolation, we talk about peer pressure, we talk about presenting yourself, we talk about being authentic, you know, using your authentic voice. So what I really hope is that the book can hold space for the person reading the book to tap into each one of those conversations. Because you can't have all those conversations in one day. I mean, you could, it'd be overwhelming though. So I hope that over time, the book is like a band-aid, it's like a support, it's like a cast, it's like a crutch, it's like a if you're one of your favorite people on a song and they're featured on the song, I want the book to be like a feature to your life that supports you, you know, and really hold space for some of those conversations, because those conversations need to be had. This is a great question right here. It says, why do you feel like it's more important to honor the release of this book versus how you have done that in the past? So here's the truth. I have 8 books out. I'm bringing my 9th one out. It should be out December 7th. I never honored the release of the other books. And the reason I never got to really honor them and cherish them and like really make a sacred ritual routine or moment or ceremony is because I was still in survival mode. Like I was still trying to get my bills paid, still trying to make sure I had a roof over my head, still trying to get my name out there, still trying to prove that I was a decent writer, a good writer, whatever the term you want to look for. You know, when I'm coming out of college and coming out of, I only worked in corporate America for about 3 to 4 years, and then I realized that was not for me. No shame, I'm just recognizing that it wasn't for me. It wasn't allowing me to fulfill myself. You know, when I first came into being an author in 2012, you know, it was terrifying. It was, the emotions were fear, unknown, uncertainty, scared. But I was also confident. Like I knew I had the skill. I knew I had the drive. I knew I had the motivation. So, you know, I was able to hold both emotions of the fear and the agony of the unknown, as well as holding on to confidence, as well as holding on to belief in myself, as well as holding on to, hey, if it doesn't work out, it's okay, but you do have to give it your best. And that's one thing that I want people to recognize in their lives, like that's one of my mindsets. It may not work out for you. The thing that you're imagining, the thing that you're hoping for, it may not work out for you. You know, one of the greatest lies ever told is that you can do anything you set your mind to. Like, I believe that you should set your mind two things, but you also need to set your energy and your actions. You need to align your life by having the right people in your life. You need to align your life by making sure you have the right mindset and the right effort, as well as, see, that's the masculine energy of pushing, creating, grinding, right? But you also need to balance it with the feminine energy of resting, right? Come back, boom, relax, go to sleep. Most people don't do that. They just do one or the other. They're either lazy or they're grinding way too much. For me, I'm all about finding that balance. Like, where is that balance where I feel like I'm giving, I'm pushing, I'm grinding, I'm creating, but I'm also healing and restoring and recovering? For me, that's super important to my mindset, to my health, to my vitality. So, you know, when the question is, I never honored my books in the past, I never honored my releases in the past. When I got up on stage and spoke to 1,000 people, to 100 people, I never really honored it. I was just so engaged in the moment that I just did it. And then it was like, hey, let's move on to the next thing. So with this book, one of the things that I want to do is really honor everything that went into this. It was a 2-year labor of love. So I really just want to slow down, honor the process, and honor the people who have helped me, you know, along the way. And so the question is, how are you going to honor it? Well, I'm for sure going to have some cookies. That's about as far as I thought. I'll probably write myself a letter and, you know, just thank myself for the effort and just thank the people who have helped me along the way and just really slow down. You know, we do so much of A to B, B to C, C to D. We just do so much jumping that honestly, we don't honor our transitions, and there's so much beauty in the transitions. So this season, one thing I want to do for sure is get some cookies and some really good water, get a really, really nice steak dinner and just, you know, be in community and really honor this book release, you know, really honor the effort, because soon I will be diving right back in. Because it's just Virgo life, man. That's how it is when you come from Chicago and you just gotta get it, you know, gotta grind and you you gotta put yourself out there. So, but before we do that, I finally matured to a point where I've learned to slow down, appreciate my effort, honor my effort. And I really hope that you can take that from this podcast for your journey, you know, really slowing down, sitting back, bringing that gratitude, the energy of gratitude to your body, to your mind, and just thanking yourself for the efforts that you have already put out. Whether you win, lose, draw, whether you finish, don't finish, today, I would love for you, I would love to invite you to just thank yourself for the efforts that you have put in. You know, don't wait till you get finished. Like, maybe you could do it today. Last question for today is this: what is your best advice for someone who is looking to finish a big goal, but they've hit a snag? Hitting a snag, having frustrations, losing something that you needed along the way as you're reaching for a goal is all a part of the story. There will be days where you'll be frustrated, you'll be down and out, you'll be defeated, you'll be bamboozled, you will be hoodwinked, you will be taking losses. But, you know, my grandmother told me, life will knock you down, but you have to get back up and stand strong, you know. And she told me that when I was in high school. I've never forgotten that. You know, you have to get back up and stand strong. And sometimes strength means you persevere and you pick it back up and you keep going. Sometimes strength means you let it go and you recognize that you gave it your best. Sometimes strength means asking for help. See, a lot of people think that being strong means doing things on your own. And I really hope that you can break up with that mindset. We need community. If you take a straw or a string, you can easily tear that thing. But if you take a whole bunch of them and intertwine them, you make it stronger. It's harder to break, it's harder to sever. You know, with that being said, I just want to encourage you and support you and say, look, you can do it. You can do it. Whatever that thing is you want to do, you can do. But the most important thing is that, like, you have to focus on it. You have to focus on it. When I come to you and I say, hey, my book is coming out December 7th, all you hear is, my new book is coming out December 7th. But you don't see the 2 years of struggle. You don't see the imposter syndrome. You don't see the doubt. You don't see the fear. All you see is that the book is coming out. And what that means is that I persevered. I pushed through. I dealt with whatever came up. Doubt came up, I dealt with it. What doubt? Why are you here? Imposter syndrome came up. Okay, you deal with it. And imposter syndrome tells you, why can't you, you know, you shouldn't do this. You're not smart enough. You're not good enough. You're not tall enough. You're not whatever. And so my question is, why not you? Instead of asking yourself, why me? Why me? The real question is, why not you? You can do this. Why not you? Why can't you be the best-selling author? Why can't you write that screenplay? Why can't you? We love Jordan Peele's movies. You probably have an idea. Why don't you write a script and honor the script writing process? Really come all the way into it. Why can't you audition for that role? Why can't you be the one to get promoted? Why can't you be the one to start that media company? Why can't you be the one to run for Congress? Why can't you be the one to make the change? Why can't you be the first one to go to college in your family? Why can't you become the first professional athlete in your family? You can do it. The very fact that you're seeing this video or hearing this podcast shows that you are aligned with this message. You can do it. You can do it. And to me, loving yourself properly means going after the things that you want in life. You know, taking care of your soul, mind, body, and spirit. With that being said, I will be back next week. There's a few more questions on this topic that I definitely want to go over. My book, Loving Yourself Properly, will be out December 7th. I'm really excited about it. This will be my 9th book. Really, really excited about what this book is, what it will mean to the community, what it means for me as an author to still be in the author world 10 years later, 9 books in. It's exciting. This is exciting stuff. With that being said, I hope you continue to free your energy.